Hello, students. We are starting a new unit today, and this one is all about similar triangles, congruent triangles, and then we're going to go into transformations later on. So the first thing that we need to do is talk about what a similar figure is, and the definition is up here at the top of the page. So similar figures are polygons, meaning shapes, that have the same shape, but they might be a different size. So you're basically imagining, you know, any shape in the world, could be this triangle, whatever, and taking your scissors tool to duplicate it. And then if you stretch it or you shrink it, they will have the same shape, but they'll be different sizes. And you might also have one that's rotated like this. It was the exact same shape, but I rotated it, and now they're in different positions, but they're still similar because it's the exact same shape, but it's just a different size. And the rotation is just to throw you off. All right, let's get rid of those guys. So another definition that helps us know if shapes are similar is corresponding. Corresponding means that two items or two dimensions have the same position. So might be like two angles that have the same position, something like that, corresponding angles. Therefore, we can say that two polygons are similar if, one, the corresponding angles are congruent, and the lengths of the corresponding sides are in a proportion. So the two things that we would have to check would be the angles. We have to check that all the angles are congruent, and we have to check the sides and check that the sides are in proportion. So the angles have to be congruent, the sides have to be in proportion. The scale factor, the last word in the definition, refers to basically what you'd have to multiply one shape by to get the dimensions of the other shape. So if it's twice as big, the scale factor is 2. If it's half as big, the scale factor is 1/2. So in a problem like this, it says show if the triangles below are similar or not. So the two things we have to check are the angles congruent? Yes or no? And are the sides proportional? Yes or no? So let's start with the angles. The first thing that we have to do is line up the angles, because right now they're not lined up in a corresponding way. There's two different ways you could do this. You could completely draw a new figure. So for example, if I'm going to keep ABC the same, then I would kind of redraw ABC and label the angles. So here's my 35 degree, here's my 90 degree, here's my 55 degree. And now I want to copy over the components of XYZ. The right angle is at Z. I can see in the picture that Z is at the right angle. The 55 degree angle is at Y, and the 35 degree angle is at X. Then I can copy over the side lengths. So between Y and Z, it's 20. So between Y and Z in my picture, I'm going to write 20. Between X and Z, it's 15. So on my picture, I'm going to write 15. And between Y and X, it's 25. So I'm going to write 25. Now I can see what matches up. I can see that the 24 has to match up with the 15. The 40 has to match up with the 25. And the 32 has to match up with the 20. And I have to see, are those proportional or not? So I'm going to start going through my checklist. First thing I need to know is, are the angles congruent, the corresponding angles? And the answer to that is yes. I was able to find a 35 degree, a 90 degree, and a 55 degree that was congruent. Here's my 35. Those are corresponding and they are congruent. Here's my right angle, corresponding and congruent. Here's my 55, corresponding and congruent. So it's okay that they were not lined up to begin with. You may have to rotate the shape. Once you rotate it, you could check if their corresponding angles are congruent. Now I have to check if the sides are proportional. And I'm not going to have enough room in this spot, so I'm going to work down below and shrink it later. So I want to check, I'm going to use colors again. So I want to check if 24 and 15 have the same ratio relationship as 40 and 25, And does that have the same ratio relationship as 32 and 20? So let's see. So 24 to 15 has to have the same relationship as 40 to 25. And that has to have the same relationship as 32 to 20. On the top row, I have all of my numbers from ABC. And on the bottom row, I have all my numbers from XYZ. You have to keep it in the same order. One way to figure this out would be just to use division, or I could reduce them down to simplest terms. So on my calculator, I could type 24 divided by 15 and see what that gives me, and hope that they're all the same. So, of course, an add. All right, go away. Try this again. All right. I just want it on the other side. Will it go there? All right, it did. 24 divided by 15 is 1.6. 40 divided by 25 is also 1.6. 32 divided by 20 is also 1.6. So yeah, they are proportional. They all equal the same thing. Go away. All right. I could also have reduced them and I would have gotten 8 over 5 equals 8 over 5 equals 8 over 5. It doesn't matter which one I had had on top. If I had done all the XYZ numbers on top, I would just have 5 eighths instead of 8 over 5. It doesn't matter. The point is that they're the same. So yes. So yes, these two triangles are similar, and this is my work to prove it. All right, I just want to shrink this out of the way. All right, going up there. Try 1 and 2 below. Pause the video. Come back when you're ready to check the work. Okay, hopefully you are ready to check the work. So for 1, since all of the angles are 90 degrees, right away, I can see that the angles are congruent. So yes. Now I have to check if the sides create a proportion. The 18 and the 25 are going to go together because that's the shorter side in the comparison. And then the 36 and the 45 will go together. So I'm going to check 18 over 25 and see if that's equal to 36 over 45. There's a lot of different ways you could check it. You could do the decimal method that I showed you before. But my eye caught a relationship right now. My eye caught that 18 times 2 is 36. So if 25 times 2 is 45, then it would be a proportion. But no, times 2 does not work. So that's another way to check if it's a proportion. So sides, no. So overall, the answer to this would be no. You could also have used the other method that I showed previously to check if they're similar or not. I'm trying to show you more than one method. All right, on number 2, same deal. And I'm going to show you another way to line up these shapes since we have to rotate one of them. In the example above, I showed you how you could redraw the second triangle. Another thing you could do is you could say, okay, well, here's my 60 degree and here's my 60 degree. So I know that T and G have to match up. So I'm just going to write a little G next to the T. I know that 30 is here and 30 is here. So I know N and R have to match up. So I can write a little R right here. And then the right angle is here and here. So I know K and P have to match up. So I can write a K here. I know that the side between R and K is 15. So right here, I have to copy down my 15. I know that the side between K and G is 8. So here's K and G. I have to write an 8 there. And I know that the side between R and G is 17. So I have to write a 17 here. So this is just another way to see how things match up. Because now I can see that 8 matches up with 16, 17 with 34, 15 with 30. First of all, my angles did match up. I was able to rotate it and get the 30, 60, 90 degrees to all line up. And then the sides, if you look at all of my new sides, all of them have this times two relationship with the original. So yeah, that is a proportion. You could also have divided them. 8 divided by 16 would be 0.5. 17 divided by 34 would be 0.5. 15 divided by 30 would be 0.5. So it works. So yes and yes. The last thing I want to go over is this question that I had skipped right over here. When two polygons are similar, we could write a similarity statement using the symbol, whatever that's called. I mean, in Spanish, it's a tilde. I don't know what it's called in English. So this is how we would write a similarity statement for each of these. Going back to our example, if I have triangle ABC, I could say that that is similar to, and usually I'd actually have a triangle symbol there. That's similar to triangle. And then I have to think about what matches up with each of those. A matched up with X. They both were 35 degrees. B matched up with Y. They were both 55 degrees. And C matched up with Z. They were both 90 degrees. So you have to put the letters in the same corresponding order so somebody else could tell which letter matches up with which letter. Down here, it's a rectangle. So rectangle A, B, C, D is congruent to rectangle. Well, in a rectangle, it doesn't matter so much. I just want the short sides to line up with the long sides, short to short, long to long. So I could just use the regular matched up order because they look the same already. W, X, Y, Z. Try to write a similarity statement for number two here. Triangle what is similar to triangle what? All right, so I wrote T, N, P, and it doesn't matter if you did a different order. If you did T, P, N, or P, N, T, it doesn't matter. I picked T, N, P. So I have to go with what I picked. T matched up with G, N matched up with R, P matched up with K. You might have had a different order, but yours needs to be corresponding. Okay, so now I want to show you what you could do if you know that the shapes are similar. So on this page, they say, find the missing side in each pair of similar figures. That means we are assuming that the angles work and the sides work. We are assuming that there is this relationship. So, let's see, in a triangle like number one, you wouldn't have to rotate anything. It's already, you could tell that they've just made it smaller, but they haven't like rotated it at all. So I can see if I use the copying over method that A and the big capital X match up, C and Z match up, B and Y match up. Between X and Z on the other triangle, I have a 6 in that spot. Between Z and Y, I have an 8 in that spot. And between X and Y, I have a 10 in that spot. So I know 6 matches with X, 10 matches with 25, and this side is not helpful. I won't be able to use the 8 to help me at all. Since they are similar, I can assume that there is a proportional relationship here. So I can say that 6 over X has to equal 10 over 25. And you might have done it upside down. If you did X over 6 equals 25 over 10, that's fine too. If you had the X on the right side, that's fine too. Now we've learned more than one way to solve this equation. One way we've learned how to solve it is to draw arrows, and then you would divide whatever the arrow is pointing to divided by the other number. So I would do 6 divided by 10, that's 0.6. And then I have to multiply 25 by 0.6. And that gives me X equals 15 when you type that into the calculator. That's one method. The other method we used, 6 over x equals 10 over 25 is cross multiplication. So in that method, we would multiply 6 times 25, which is 150, and we'd multiply 10 times x, which is 10x, and then we'd solve the equation. Divide both sides by 10, and you get x equals 15. So you could use either one of those methods to solve it. So either way, answer to number one is 15. Some of these problems will ask you to solve for more than one variable. Like here, they're making you solve it once for x. Then you have to start over and solve it again for y. So that means that you'll have to use the 15 in your proportion because it's the only side that you're going to know matches up with something else. You wouldn't be able to use the x and y in your proportion together because that's two variables. So you have to use the 15 with the x, then you have to use the 15 with the y. The last thing I want to show you is a problem like number 5 when it's two triangles that are kind of on top of each other. So what we basically have here is we have a big triangle, which is JKL. So I'm going to copy this over. I would not normally copy it over. I'm copying it over to show it to you. The sides of JKL are 15. We do not know the side of this. And then J to K is 4 plus 6, which is 10. That's JKL. Usually I would think about this in my head. The other triangle we have is GKH. So in GKH, I have K to G is 6. This is X, so I probably shouldn't use X over here then, because I just made up that. I'm going to just say it's question mark, because we don't really need that. And I know nothing about K to H. So for both of these triangles, I know the left-hand side and the bottom. So here's my proportion. 10 over 6 equals 15 over x. As long as your 10 is diagonal from your 15, or I'm sorry, as long as your 10 is diagonal from your x, you have it set up correctly. But your numbers might be in different positions. Pause the video, solve this proportion, come back when you're ready to check the work. All right, I'm going to use the cross multiplication. So that means I'm going to be multiplying 10 times x. And I'm going to be multiplying 6 times 15. Doesn't matter which one I do first. 10 times x is 10x. 6 times 15 is 90. Divide both sides by 10. And I get x equals 9.